Where's My Fortune Cookie? My psychic, surrealistic story, as told by Firesign Theatre's Phil Proctor and co-authored by Brad Schreiber. This book is dedicated to my darling wife, Melinda. A foreword into the past. Half of what I remember never happened. Mark Twain. What is reality? The Firesign Theatre. Dear friends, this book starts off with a bang, or several, as you'll soon learn. And it's not your typical biography, because I have, I believe, not lived a typical life. Or maybe I have. You'll have to tell me, since time is an illusion of sorts, and I believe that we exist as much in the minds of others as we do in our own. It's a crazy chronicle, at best, which I hope will inspire you to listen to your own inner voices and trust in higher consciousness to guide you on your way to enlightenment, or at least to a feeling of personal fulfillment and self-realization, as you, too, represent a significant sliver of potential in this shattered, isolated experience we call existence on this dimension, Earth. Serendipity rules. The book is based on taped interviews I did with my co-author and friend, funny man Brad Schreiber, who coerced me over breakfast one morning to begin the challenging task of telling my story before I could no longer remember it. Maybe he was too late, but you'll never know. And I've done my best to protect others from embarrassment, or me from lawsuits, by eliminating some turbulent times. In other words, may my lost years remain lost. I'm still alive and kicking, so who cares? Finally, a huge thank you to all those whose support and love have contributed to the birth of the book. My daughter Kristen, and her husband Jeff, and my grandkids Bowen and Audrey. The Firesign Theatre, Phil, Pete, and Dave, and Andy Thomas, and Taylor Jessen, and Brad, and Jamie Alcroft for dragging me onto boomers on a bench. Thank me, and I'm welcome. Phil Proctor. Chapter 1. Try the Duck. You'll notice that the subtitle of this book is My Psychic, Surrealistic Story, because beyond being functionally illiterate, my life seems to be punctuated with the sort of improbable premonitions and creepy close calls that might comfortably comprise an episode of The Twilight Zone. Perhaps all of our lives are adrift in this surreal domain, but it is the unique blessing or curse of artists to be acutely aware of and informed by the psychic currents that swirl around us. It is the connective tissue between us, the glue that bonds actor and audience, and it's a heavy responsibility to remain lighthearted. My life has been in collaboration with gifted colleagues on stage and on the page, and I've come to understand that performing is not just a matter of remembering lines and hitting your marks. It's about celebrating the human condition. It's an expression of love, and love is not linear. So, like all the best stories, allow me to start in the middle. The last album Firesign Theatre did for Columbia Records, In the Next World You're on Your Own, 1975, had a hidden meaning for not only listeners but for me as well, because 2 years later, my comedy partner Peter Bergman and I would stare death in the face in one of the first major American mass shootings. The album was written by Dave Ossman and Phil Austin, but featured all four of our voices. It opens with Police Street, a wacky send-up of cop shows in which we hear a burst of gunfire and a police radio call about unarmed tourist victims. Correction, one unarmed tourist. The other two had arms. Little did we know that something like this would actually happen to us in the early morning hours of September 4th, 1977. Soon after the release.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.